गेट रेडी फॉर द डिक्टेशन ऑन द काउंट ऑफ 3, 2, 1 स्टार्ट. मिस्टर डेप्यूटी चेयरमैन सर, इन रिगार्ड टू द फाइनेंस बिल वी हैव सबमिटेड डिटेल्ड अमेंडमेंट्स एंड हेंस आई शैल कन्फाइन माई सेल्फ नाउ टू द जनरल पॉलिसी बिहाइंड द फाइनेंस बिल. द डिटेल्ड प्रपोजल्स वी शैल डील विद when the amendments are taken up. Sir, in presenting the finance bill based on the budget, the finance minister has delinked the price rise of petroleum and fertilizer from the budget proposals. He has delinked the price rise to the extent of rupees 2700 crores. This petroleum and fertilizer price rise, coupled with the imports of about rupees 204 crores in the railway budget and rupees 445 crores in this budget in a full year, which comes to a total of about rupees 3400 crores, have had a very strong effect on the prices. These budget proposals have increased the inflationary pressure in the country. It is clear that the inflation this year will be a two-digit inflation. The national newspapers have predicted a 30% price rise. Some economists have said a price rise of 15 to 20% is inevitable. As the finance minister has delinked the petroleum and fertilizer price rise from the budget, he has also delinked the anti-inflationary proposals from the budget. The budget is the weakest so far as the price policy or the anti-inflation policy is concerned. We have very great and an almost precedented price rise. I think the government had already said that the prices of petroleum products have risen by 37%, the price of oil has risen by 25%, the prices of all other commodities have risen by 10.5%. This is government's own admission. This is government's own admission. Hence, in view of this unprecedented price rise, we had hoped for a massive, determined and resolute policy for controlling the prices. In the short run, you control the prices by strengthening the public distribution system. In the long run, you control the prices by increasing production. But so far as the public distribution system is concerned, there is not much emphasis on it in the budget. One of the colleagues of the finance minister has said in one discussion that he does not believe in any control. He said he believes in self-control by the trading people here. This kind of a statement creates confusion. But if we have to stop the price rise, there should be a strong public distribution system. But in our country, we have only 2.14 lakh fair price shops for a population of 700 million. Therefore, there has to be budgetary support to strengthen our public distribution system, and we have to have greater budgetary support for essential commodities whose shortage we are having. The allocation for textile mills in the public sector, which are to produce controlled cloth, has also been reduced. Government should have a very firm policy so far as prices are concerned. So far as speculators, hoarders and black marketers are concerned, prices are rising. Stocks are being built up and inventory is going up. Speculation is taking place by money from two sources, one from regular bank money and the other from black money. With regard to regular bank money, after the finance minister nationalized 6 banks, we have control over 91% of the banking resources. Still, some credit is going to speculators because there is a cultural norm that whoever was getting credit will go on getting credit. Therefore, on credit policy, there has to be greater surveillance and greater money check so that those who hoard do not get credit. Otherwise, this anti-inflationary policy will not succeed. This is so far as white money going to speculation and hoarding is concerned. So far as black money going into hoarding and speculation is concerned, on black money, the Venture Committee was there. It had pointed out that 8,000 crores of rupees of black money were circulating into the market. Somebody said that it is rupees 20,000 crores and somebody's estimate is still higher. It is said that there has been a tax evasion of about rupees 1400 crores. Therefore, on black money, the finance minister has to take strong and firm action. The raids are not taking place, and sometimes when the raids take place, there is something flashed in the newspapers, but later nothing comes out of it. Therefore, strong and firm measures are to be taken so far as black money holders and profiters are concerned. On black money, the question of bearer bonds was also mooted. It was not successful in Ceylon. About the steps, I would not ask the finance minister to disclose to the house, but I would ask him to take them as he did it in the case of nationalization of 6 major banks for which he deserves credit. So in black money, I hope the finance minister will do something very, very firm without giving any warning to anybody about the steps.